Brenda and CJ are nominated for eviction, but Curtis holds the golden power veto. Will he use it? Find out now on Big Brother Cheesecake for Office Wars. Hello, I'm Andrew Shevsek-Moonves. Welcome to Big Brother Cheesecake for Office Wars. It's day 56 inside the Big Brother Cheesecake house, and this week Brazil is the head of household. She nominated Brenda and CJ for eviction, but Curtis won the Golden Power Veto in the Big Brother Silent Auction Power Veto competition and must decide whether to use it to save Brenda or CJ from the chopping block. What will he do? We'll find out shortly. But first, yesterday was a very quiet day inside the Big Brother Cheesecake house. In fact, I would say, because this season is sort of in the spring-summer, and it was because of the pandemic that I obviously made this season happen when it did, we're getting into the summer now, and I find that on weekends, everybody's sort of doing things outdoors, and they're rediscovering themselves, and Kat's going to Arby's, and Marcin is going to Arby's, and, you know, so everybody's busy. And so that's okay, but it does make the house quieter on the weekends. And so I was going to do this tomorrow, but I'm going to move it up to today. We're going to have Joanne show us one of her favorite summer recipes. And I'm warning you now, Chantal, just push the fast forward now, because it doesn't get worse than what's coming. Okay. I'm Joanne! In case anybody needs reminding, since you're not talking about me very much, I hate Charlene. She's a big meanie. Today, since summer's coming, I'm going to show you my favorite summer recipe. It's called a Ramen Raisin Nanaimo Bar Sundae. I love it. First, you take ramen raisin ice cream from La Paloma on St. Clair and Lansdowne. You know it's authentic because when it melts brown. Then we need to add the Nanaimo bar. So, first, we have these coconut cocoa pebbles from Wegmans in Buffalo. The Americans have so much better cereal than we do. Canadian cereal sucks, so I go to Wegmans in Buffalo to buy coconut cocoa puffs. But Buffalo's not a good place to go this time of year, because if you get lost and you ask a police officer for the latest for the directions to Olive Garden, he'll just push you over. What a bunch of self-righteous pricks! So, chomp up your cocoa puffs. You know what? Maybe you should just sit on them. That ought to work. This is so exciting. I'm going to sit on the cocoa puffs. That's good cocoa puffs. Okay, then. Well, I didn't do a good job with them. Anyway, put the cocoa puffs onto your ramen raisin ice cream. There it goes. It's like magical. You're almost at your Ramen Raisin Nanaimo Bar Sundae. Yes, look at that. The next step is the chocolate. So we're going to use another one of my favorites, the Lindt Chocolate Bunny. I think I'm going to sit on this one too. Why isn't this working? Oh, and make sure when you're making it, you use your St. Michael's College School for Demented Sex Pervert clothing. Yes. Excuse me for a minute. I have to just get something out of the way here. Okay. 1 second. Okay. All right. And then
You can sit on the mint chocolate bunny too when you make this. I'm Joanne. Make sure you sit on it real good. Chantal, I hope you're fast-forwarding through this. I think I crushed it. I sure did. That felt good. Okay, so then you got your Lindt chocolate bunny. So take a few pieces of the Lindt chocolate bunny and put it right over your creation. So exciting. Now, the next step is the butter. Your butter needs to be churned. So what you're going to do is you're going to put the butter in between your boobs and you're going to churn it real good. That's good churning. Okay. Now, the recipe calls for 1 teaspoon, but fuck it. I'm not on a diet, so I'll just do that much. There you go. And to top it all off, my favorite, you can't go wrong with Aunt Jemima's butter syrup. If you get regular, you're an idiot. That's good. And there you have it, folks. A rum and raisin Nanaimo bar sundae. I think I'll take a bite right now. Gotta get a piece with all the layers.
No, it's actually good. Fuck. That wasn't the point. It's supposed to suck. Anyway.
Pro tip, don't use salted butter. That doesn't work. Unless it's a salted caramel ramen raisin Nanaimo bar bunny. Actually, the salted one works too.
Excuse me.
Bye, everyone. I think that's going to be the last of my recipes this season. Sorry about that, but I'll give you something fun to remember me by. I'm going to take the escalator down this time. Bye!
Okay, so, that actually tasted good. But, yeah. Sorry. Now it's time to get to the Golden Power Veto Ceremony. How does that even... Never mind. Hello there! I'm Curtis, and I won the Golden Power Veto, and it is my responsibility... And I have the opportunity to remove one of the two nominees from the chopping block. Brenda, why should I use the Golden Power Veto to save you? Curtis, I want to congratulate you on your excellence and want you to know, my grace, that I appreciate everything that you do, and there are no hard feelings, and I actually think you are quite smashing and charming, and I want to... tip my top hat to you. Why, thank you, Brenda. CJ, why should I use the Golden Power Veto to save you?
How in the flying fuck is Brenda still here? I mean, she is being so quick as she comes back. Shit. And why is this rum and raisin in the Nanaimo bar sundae has so little rum? I wanna have a rum and raisin and rum in the Nanaimo bar sundae. That's what I wanna do. There you go. Now it's a nice sundae. Yes. Thanks. Yes. So, I wanna let everybody know
that Brandon's still here somehow. That's bullshit. So if it works for her, it works for me. Curtis?
I've decided not to use the Golden Power of Veto. Along with the fact that I want to respect the head of household's nominations, it's been clear from the beginning of the week that everyone in the house was scared of the Ruby Veto and wanted that out of the house. Nothing personal against Brenda whatsoever. We may have had our differences, but I respect you a lot, Brenda, and I wish you all the best. You might not believe it, CJ, but it was made sure that it was going to be a unanimous vote for you to stay. The house was unanimous in that you were not the target, so I'm glad it worked out that way so you can continue to play. With that said, this Golden Power Veto ceremony is adjourned. Brenda or CJ, who will be evicted? Watch tomorrow as they plead their case to stay in the game and we learn the rules of the next head of household competition and check in with Rai Rai in the jury house. And Wednesday is the live eviction and head of household competition where another house guest will be fired from Dunder Mifflin, evicted from the Big Brother Cheesecake Forehouse, lose their shot at the $400 Cheesecake Factory gift card, and become the second member of the jury. I'm Andrew Shevsik Moonbest. Take care and relieve you as we eavesdrop on the house guests. Good night.